Procedures shown may not be current or airline specific. Do not use for real-life flying. While in cruise at 34,000 feet, the master caution light comes on. The pilot flying immediately states, "My aircraft," making sure someone is maintaining aircraft control, while the pilot monitoring deals with the issue. ENG is illuminated on the first officer's enunciator panel, which indicates an issue on the overhead panel. A look at the bleed air control panel reveals the bleed trip-off light is illuminated. This indicates excessive bleed air temperature or overpressure. A look at the pneumatic duct pressure indicator shows zero bleed air pressure from the right engine as the engine bleed valve is now closed. If applicable, the QRC is checked for the procedure, followed by the Quick Reference Handbook or QRH. The bleed trip-off procedure is located in the QRH and found under B, with the wording shown on the illuminated light. Both pilots must agree it's the correct checklist before performing it. In this case, the checklist condition is for an engine bleed air overheat or overpressure. The procedure not only has the wording from the illuminated light, it also shows an image of the light, which matches the illuminated light on the panel. The first step is to turn off the wing anti-ice switch if on. Next, we push the trip reset switch. The note below states that the bleed air trip-off light extinguishes if the bleed air temperature has cooled below limits, which is 254 degrees Celsius or 490 degrees Fahrenheit. After pressing the reset switch, we can see the light extinguished and the right engine duct pressure is increasing. Step 3 is conditional. Did the bleed trip-off light stay illuminated or not? If it had stayed illuminated, the right pack would have been switched off and icing conditions avoided. This would have completed the checklist. However, when we pushed the reset button, the light extinguished, so the checklist directs us to step 4. Step 4 indicates that the wing anti-ice switch can be used as needed. The caution message states that use of wing anti-ice above approximately flight level 350 may cause bleed trip-off and possible loss of cabin pressure. We are already below that altitude. The four black boxes below indicate that the checklist has now been completed. Please subscribe to learn of future videos, when we'll cover more non-normal procedures. Thank you.